What are the benefits of Tesamorelin? So there's been a lot of talk about growth hormone and what it does to the body, and is it safe, is it not safe? And in this video, I'll deconstruct some of the safety issues, but more importantly, I'm going to show you what the research shows and how this was approved over 10 years ago, like 2012, it was approved for a condition called lipodystrophy. And that's where we develop visceral fat and belly fat, and how you can use Tesamorelin to get rid of that. So let's jump into the science. So the benefits of Tesamorelin are so broad, but one of the big things that people forget is the workhorse in your body called your liver. Your liver is so powerful because if you have an optimized liver, you're going to have better digestion, better detoxification, and more importantly, you're going to have hormonal optimization. What's funny is a lot of people, when they get hormonal imbalances, they just get put on testosterone or growth hormone, or they start taking gear and they think, I just wanna get bigger and I just wanna be stronger and I just wanna look better, but they fail to look at the underlying cause. And so your liver is really powerful because it has roughly 400 digestive and detoxification functions. And then it's got about 200 hormonal functions. And the liver is interesting because it's the one organ in our body that can regenerate. I mean, if you think of the story of Prometheus, he was the Greek god who told humans how to make fire. And fire was the first technology that humans learned how to utilize. And arguably, it made our diet more broad. It allowed us to travel great distances. It helped us, you know, form into almost 8 billion great humans on the planet today, which I love humans on the planet, all you non-humaners out there. I want 10 billion, 20 billion. It's going to be fun. But I want you guys all healthy and optimized, and that's why I make these videos. So if you like them, make sure you subscribe. So Prometheus, what happened to him is he was chained to a rock, and every day he would have part of his liver pecked out. The eagle would come and take out part of his liver and eat it, and then his liver would regenerate, and then the next day the eagle would come again. So even the Greek, in Greek mythology, they understood the power of your liver. Now, the liver is important because if it starts to get necrotic, or if the tissue starts to die, then it's harder for your body to detoxify. And a lot of times your liver can be underperforming and it doesn't show up on blood labs until it's almost too late. And so the liver, the other thing that they found, the liver is very pliable. I mean, it's like a sponge. And it's got the most density for needing vitamins and minerals, and specifically B vitamins, because what the B vitamins do is they help activate methylation and detoxification. The liver is also where we process iron. So if you think of the energy production in your body, we all need iron. If you don't believe me, just go anemic. Be anemic for a while and watch your hair fall out and watch your bones get weak and your energy completely zapped. But the liver is necessary because there's a gene called the cytochrome P450, and iron is what activates the detoxification pathway. So you go from phase one, where you take water-soluble to fat-soluble molecule, and then you break it down into phase two, and then phase three is where we excrete it. Antioxidants are the byproduct of this process. But your liver is what's governing all of those things. Your liver is also responsible for unconjugating hormones so that the hormones can get excreted out of your body. So if you've ever done hormone replacement therapy and it made things worse, even though your hormones are deficient, then you want to look at optimizing your liver, detoxifying it. You also want to look at your gut. There's a pathway called beta-glucuronidase. If that pathway is not working properly, it's going to be really hard for you to get rid of estrogens. And so then you can become estrogen dominant even when you're deficient. It's crazy what the liver can do. In the studies with Tesamorelin, what they found is a lot of these HIV patients, they're on a lot of medication, and these medications, some of the side effect, it caused them to put on visceral fat and belly fat. And so these patients, they also couldn't build muscle. And so what the researchers did is they said, what if we use this peptide called Tesamorelin, which is 44 amino acid chains, and let's see what we can do with the liver. Let's see if we can activate growth hormone and build more muscle. Let's also see what it can do for them cognitively. And what they found is many of these patients had fibrotic livers because of the medications they were on. Many of them had been abusing drugs. And what they found, and they had hepatitis C, but what they found is in some cases where they had even a 90% fibrotic liver, Tesamorelin was able to help regenerate the liver. So it's really powerful on that angle. The other thing you can do for your liver is making sure you get lots of cruciferous vegetables in. Cook those cruciferous vegetables, but once you start intaking those vegetables, that fibrous content and the sulforaphane, which is one of the active ingredients in cruciferous vegetables, it will help your liver detox and you can clear out old senescent cells, and it's a massive gateway for longevity that's not talked about. The liver is probably one of the most fascinating organs in the body, not just because Prometheus, that was his eternal doom, is having his liver pecked out and eaten part of the year, but the other fascinating thing with it, but if you think of the superfood on the planet, it's liver. And so, yes, Paul Saladino, I love your videos with you eating raw liver in the morning. That may be a little extreme for those of us who are not quite as connected to our caveman ancestry. But if you see, like, even pack animals, the first thing they eat is the liver or the heart. And that's in large part because of its nutrient density. The liver, if you're eating liver, you don't have to eat it, by the way, you can take liver capsules, but what you'll see is there's phenomenal peptides in the liver to activate your own liver pathways. You're going to see massive quantities of vitamin A, and this beta carotene is so good for your eyes. So anything like orange, or you can eat beets. Beets are phenomenal for your liver. The other thing you'll have when you eat liver is you're going to have a much better profile of iron. And this iron can help you in that whole detoxification process. So by taking tesamorelin, which activates growth hormone, you also want to think detoxification in the liver. And anytime you're trying to build muscle mass and trying to optimize your longevity and build muscle mass without having side effects when using growth hormone peptides, is just think of liver. And so I like using binders. So I use a whole protocol with CellCor, and I'll use biotoxin binders. I want to make sure that there's no mycotoxins or mold in my body. I want to make sure I'm not getting plastics in. And Brian Johnson, thank you for your plastics test. I learned that I was in like the top 98 percentile of no plastics in my body, because I've been pretty obsessed with, you know, eliminating plastics. But you can use these binders, these short chain and medium chain binders, to help strip things out of your liver. You can use milk thistle. I know a lot of you ask about that, but don't use that long term, or you can start getting a little more estrogen in your body. So cycle these things, even these binders. Activated charcoal is great to use for the liver, for the detoxification, but you want to make sure that it's not used with food, because it will strip out some of the nutrients. You don't want to use it around any of these peptides. You want to have a nice gap between, so like right before bed or first thing in the morning, something like that. But tesamorelin, if you really want it to work the way that it's designed to, you want to think of these liver pathways. The other thing that I love utilizing with tesamorelin is called NAC, or N-acetylcysteine. And these are precursors for glutathione, and technically it's three peptides. So if you stack glutathione with the tesamorelin, you'll see that the detoxification works better. And for those of you who have like that MTHFR variant, or you've ran your genetics and you just don't methylate well, then this is where you can use methylated B vitamins. You can use folate. You can use the methylated B12 called methylcobalamin. These things work really well for assisting the liver. You can use niacin, B3, a lot of you are deficient in that, and then vitamin B6. All of which are contained in liver. So if you look at all the benefits of tesamorelin, you want to think, okay, it's regenerative for my liver. How else can I help the liver pathway? So you want to build in lifestyles that accompany and complement the peptide. I mean, yes, it's common sense, but one of the things tesamorelin also does is it reduces inflammation in your body, and specifically inflammation in the liver. Tesamorelin turns on the gene that activates better cognitive function and recall and verbal composite, so you have better verbal fluency. But tesamorelin is also really powerful because of its regenerative properties and burns off the visceral fat. One of the biggest detriments to your future health, to your muscle building, to your cognitive capabilities, and your cardiovascular system is when you have this visceral fat that spits off all this pro-inflammatory, these cytokines that drive down the function of your body. So just by eliminating that belly fat with tesamorelin, activating more muscle, exercising every day, and then getting your cruciferous vegetables, eat some liver, take some liver capsules. I like the ancestral blend. So in your area, if you have like a natural grocer's, they have these blends of meat, and usually it's like bison, you know, hamburger patty that you can make out of it, but it's got heart and it's got liver in there. And yes, you can taste the organ meat some, but it's really not bad. I've got a good friend who's a neighbor of mine, Derek, and if you see this video, you're awesome. He's like a genius engineer. His wife, Laura, is just phenomenal too, just a brilliant marketer and advertiser. But if you think of Derek, he grew up in Poland and he grew up eating liver. And so we were making liver stew for our dogs and he's like, oh, I was hoping we were having that for dinner. He just has acquired a taste for it. I know many of us, the taste is not great. I don't mind it, but it's not something that I crave like Derek does. But this can be a great way of accelerating the benefits of tesamorelin. The other thing is when you get your exercise in, don't just count your reps. Make sure you're going until failure. Really push yourself. Nikki on our fitness team, she's phenomenal. She's got her master's degree in exercise kinesiology, and she can help push you beyond what you thought your limitations were. You work with Tristan. Many of you have worked with Tristan Slagowski. Once again, he's a very strong individual, very athletic. And he pushes you to the point where, you know, it's not going to induce injury, but it's actually going to increase that hypertrophy. So these are ways that you can take tesamorelin, increase the benefits. And for those of you who love the studies, there's resources that we'll provide. Tesamorelin works on non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. It helps regenerate and reduce that. Tesamorelin reduces liver fat and fibrosis progression in people who do have HIV, lipodystrophy. Tesamorelin impacts visceral fat and liver fat. Tesamorelin improves liver function. Tesamorelin, this injectable growth hormone peptide, has been found to reverse signs of liver disease. I mean, the research goes on and on. So think of how can you give your liver some love today, do some twisting movements, do some jump ropes. The more active you are, the more you help move that detoxification. And if you love this video, then you're gonna wanna check out my video on how much tesamorelin can I take, and we'll provide a link in the show notes below. I'm Regan Archibald. Appreciate you being part of the community here at Ageless Future.